Hello students, today we will study our first chapter, The Tiny Teacher from Supplementary Reader. Before starting the chapter, I want to ask you, name the smallest and wisest insect. Is it fly? No. It is mosquito? No. I will tell you, it is an ant. Ant is the smallest and wisest creature. So in this chapter, we will study the fact about the tiny, intelligent and hardworking creature that is ant. The story of an ant's life is too remarkable to be true. An ant is the smallest and wisest creature that we have seen. An ant uses its feelers or antenna to talk to other ants by passing message through them. They greet each other by touching their feelers. Do you know where the ants live? Ants have comfortable homes known as ant hills. Each home has hundreds of little rooms and passage. In some of these rooms, the queen ant lays egg. Others are nursery for the young ants called grubs. Workers have their reserve quarters. Some rooms serve as storehouses for food. Soldiers have separate bunkers. Ants in a house never quarrel with each other like the human beings. Each ant does its shares of work intelligently and bravely. So the ants led a very peaceful life. We know so many other facts about ants' life. People have kept ants as pet. They have watched their daily behavior closely. An ant uses its feeler or antenna to talk or to greet the other's ant. There are many kinds of ants. The common one among them are black and red ones. The queen ant has a pair of wings which she casts off, that means bite off or leave off, before she begins to lay eggs. Eggs hatch and become grubs. These grubs change into cocoon and cocoon break to bring forth complete ants. This is the life cycle of ant. Cocoons take 3, 4, or 4 weeks to become perfect ants. Thus, it takes 5 or 6 weeks for a grub to become a complete ant. When the eggs become grubs, soldiers guard them. They used to take care of them. Worker ants carry the grubs out for airing, exercise, and sunshine. New ants are trained for the jobs of workers like soldiers, builders, cleaners, etc. That means every ant is having their particular work to do, and they are doing their work very perfectly. After a few weeks training, the small ants are ready to go out for work. That means they have become an adult and they are ready to do work. Creatures other than the ants also live in the anthill. These are beetles, lesser breeds of ants, and the green fly. Some of them give smell pleasing to the ants. Others give various juices, and some are just pets or playing thing. The ants train green fly to give honeydew. They milk it just as we milk the cow. Man learned many things from the ant, the tiny teacher. Hard work, sense of duty, discipline, cleanliness,
and care for young ones are some of them. But other than this, human beings learn a lot from ant. Above all, an ant has firm loyalty to the land where it lives. Hard work is easy to see as each ant does its duty most regularly. Sense of duty and discipline are the most important quality of an ant's life. So here, the moral of the story is, we should learn three things from the tiny teacher, that is, hard work, sense of duty, and discipline. So student, from this chapter, you have to learn all these three things and should involve in your life to become a good citizen of this country. So thank you.